What's up, everybody? It's G from Foods and Dudes. We're back with another episode. I'm here today with the man, my homie, Big Colin. What's going on, brother?
What's up, my man?
How are you?
I'm good. I'm good.
Thank you for having me out here.
Thank you for doing this.
I appreciate you. Now you're on blast.
That's all right.
Now you're on blast.
That's all right. That's all right. I'm going to show you my skills.
Yeah,
I'm saying. Life skills.
We talked and you said you were good with this.
I'm good with this. So I like the big mic.
That's what's up. We call this Excalibur.
That's right.
This is Excalibur. That's what we're going to do. All right, so what we're going to do is we got three things going on today.
Okay.
All right, so the first is a skirt steak.
Right.
All right, we're just going to do this pan-seared skirt steak. It cooks very fast, very flavorful.
Yes.
It's a great piece of meat, man. This is from the bottom of the cow. It's a great beefy flavor.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to season this up with a nice rub, man. We're going to add some chili pepper, some garlic, a little bit of ginger, some dill.
Okay.
Some thyme, some salt and pepper, obviously.
We season our food. We're gonna rub
that on and just let that sit for a few minutes.
Right.
All right. So that's what's gonna happen. Then we're gonna do the potatoes. All right.
Okay.
We're doing medallion sweet potatoes. This is a little thing I like to do.
Right.
All right. So we're gonna cut these into basically little circles.
Okay.
We're gonna drop it in the pan with some butter, some cinnamon, and some sugar.
Yes.
And just let that, you know, just all absorb.
Okay.
You know, it's gonna give you this beautiful orange color, beautiful flavor.
Right.
All right. So sweetness to go against the savory flavor of the beef and the meat and everything. So that's gonna be excellent. And then we're gonna top the beef off with a chimichurri. Now that's an Argentinian sauce. It's a really delicious topping.
Bright green.
It's bright a bright green thing.
Yes.
So actually, mine's gonna be a little bit more red.
Okay.
So it's gonna be green and red, which will complement the meat. It'll make the plate look pretty also,
right.
But it tastes delicious. So we got some yellow pepper, some red pepper. We're gonna add in some salt, some paprika for a little bit more redness in that taste. Some chopped garlic, some hot red pepper. And what do we got over there? Some oregano, all right?
Okay.
And of course, cilantro and parsley. So we're gonna cut all that up, drop in some red wine vinegar, some olive oil, mix it all together, makes this beautiful sauce for the meat.
Okay.
It's gonna be wonderful.
All right,
so.
I'm ready.
All right, so you know, we're gonna test your skills today. You talk a lot.
Got it.
All right, so we're gonna start with the rub. So I'm gonna switch sides with you because everything is over here.
All right, bro.
All right.
Got it.
So. Here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna create a nice rub.
Okay. All right?
So the difference between spicing something, you know, freehand and using a rub is what I wanna do is I'm gonna take a mason jar.
Okay.
We're gonna put all the ingredients in here instead of just sprinkling it on the meat directly.
Gotcha.
The reason why I like to do that is because as you put it in here, you're gonna shake it up.
Okay.
You know you have equal parts of everything. All right. So that's the point of the rub. We want everything to be nice and even so every bite tastes the same. Okay.
All right.
We want it to taste like what we want it to taste like.
Yeah,
so,
man, you sound like you know what you're doing.
A little bit. You know what I mean? So, let me move these out of the way so all our people can see what's going on.
Okay.
All right. What we're going to do is add the ingredients. So, this is dill.
Okay.
Do me a favor, just put that whole thing in. That's about a teaspoon of dill. I just measured that previously.
Okay.
All right. That's thyme.
Thyme.
That's about a teaspoon and a half of thyme. So, throw that in there. Here's the spoons.
Okay.
All right. We're going to add some ginger.
Okay.
So the ginger,
a little bit.
No, we're gonna put about a teaspoon of ginger also.
Okay, all right, a teaspoon.
Yep.
There you go.
Got it.
I got it.
All right. See that education? He read.
You know, I was reading. You know, reading's fundamental. You know what I'm saying?
All right, 2 teaspoons of garlic.
Okay.
I like a nice garlicky flavor on this steak, this cut of steak.
Garlic powder is the truth.
Absolutely.
There you go.
And a touch of chili powder. Okay.
A touch. So
just
I'm gonna get a
touch. We're gonna do a quarter teaspoon or a half teaspoon. So that's a half teaspoon. That's as far as it goes, but don't fill it all the way. So
I'm
gonna
fill
that
all the way.
There we go. We don't want it to be hot.
Nah, that heat, man.
All right.
I sweat enough already.
Okay. Now we're gonna add some salt.
Okay.
All right. Now we've had some salt incidents.
Yes, I've seen that. I've seen that.
I want you to show the people that it actually works and bam. Look at that. Now keep it coming.
Okay.
Alright. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Alright. Now what I did just now is a little unorthodox, but I happen to know my machine. I know that if I count to 10 like that, that's about a teaspoon of salt.
Okay,
so that's the reason why I did that.
Okay.
Now we're gonna add some coarse pepper. I have 2 different shakers. This is fine pepper, this is coarse.
All right.
Yeah, so just we're gonna add a little bit of pepper.
And that works too.
Look at that. Look at that.
Hot tech, boy. Love it.
People on this show had me, you know, acting like I was giving them faulty equipment. You know, it's all good. Okay, all right, cool. So that's about it. And that's pretty much it. So this is all we need for this.
Okay.
Right, so I'm just putting the top on. I just need you to shake that up.
I'm real good at this. Look at this.
Look at that.
Hot tech. Look at the swirl right there. We swirling it. We up and down. We swirling it around. Revolutions.
Nice. All right. So we straight. All right. Okay. That's all we need. And now we're just going to get a nice sprinkle on the meat. All right. So nothing too heavy, but get a nice sprinkle on the meat.
All right. Testing.
I'm testing you. Testing
you. Listen, you said you knew what you were doing, man.
I know what I'm doing, baby. I'm good. I'm covering it all. So get that on. All right. Now, what's the thing with a rub? This is a piece of beef. So for real, we rub the meat. We hit it and we rub the meat. We physically rub the meat. The spice into the meat.
Right.
Okay.
We rub massaging it.
So you must.
This is a little more central than I thought it was going to be.
Hey, listen.
All rubbed.
So we're going to flip and do the same thing, okay? So we're just going to flip the meat over, do the same thing on the other side.
I'm going to get the flip going my dang self.
There you go.
Look at that. I'm high tech, Pete.
There you go. Now, this is a beautiful piece of skirt steak.
Yeah. All
right? I was telling the producers earlier that, you know, when you get a nice cut of meat, you can really do some nice things with it. You know what I mean?
Right.
If you get a terrible piece of meat, it's tough. So when you buy your meat, just make sure you buy quality stuff. You know what I mean? Like, you just don't want, you know, any old thing that they throw in some styrofoam or whatever else. Get a good cut of meat.
Find yourself a good butcher.
Find yourself a great butcher. Now this is done. This steak will take about 4 to 6 minutes to cook, actually.
Okay.
All right, so 2 minutes on each side is more than enough. This is about, I would say, a quarter inch to maybe a half inch thick at the thickest part.
Right.
So it cooks very quickly. The last thing you want is a tough piece of meat.
Right.
After you do all of this stuff. So what we're going to do is take this, put it off to the side. It'll be pretty much the last thing we cook.
Okay.
All right. Because that'll take, this will be the quickest thing. So we're going to move this out of the way. Oh, that's this. Whoa. As our audience knows, we have had some problems.
I've seen this part.
With moving the meat to the kitchen.
So let's just drop this in the fridge.
Oh,
it's all right. Cut.
Nah, I'm straight, bro.
It's everywhere.
I said a little prayer before I touched the board.
So here's what we're going to do.
Make sure we're good.
We're going to grab it with a good grip.
Yes, of course.
Of course.
We're not going to use our pinkies.
We're going to take some caution. And
I got you, bro.
And move this over that way. All right?
Watch
look at that.
Watch my skills.
Look at that. Five fingers.
I'm on the move. Here we go. The meat is secured. I'm your boy right here. This is easy stuff.
You are the first person who has moved the beef from the table to the kitchen without dropping it. I appreciate you for that. I got skills.
All right. Grip.
All right. Good to go. All right. So here's what we got to do next, man. What we're going to do is the sweet potato medallions. And what we're going to do is just slice up the potatoes. So we're not going to peel potatoes on the show because how much fun is that? You saw somebody peel potatoes for like the whole show one time. We're not going to do that again.
It's a hard knock life.
Okay, so in the interest of time, I've actually peeled a couple of sweet potatoes already, okay?
Okay.
All right, now we're doing this at this point because it's easier to do this now, get them cooking, so by the time we're finished with everything else, the potatoes will be done. For this particular meal, this is what's going to take the longest, all right? So these need to simmer for 15, 20 minutes or so.
Gotcha.
So that's the deal. So all we're going to do for these is we're going to make medallions out of them. You know what? Big guy, I'm going to give you a big knife.
Yeah, man.
We're going to do this. Yeah, this looks like more your speed.
That's what I'm talking about.
That looks like more your speed. You good? I feel like
that's my Thundercat right there.
I feel like I need to arm myself.
That's my Thundercat right there.
You look like a little too happy for that. I'm glad I've known you a long time. All right, so we're just going to cut these. We don't need the ends. But we're just going to cut these half inch maybe. All right.
Okay.
So we just want to look nice little medallions. All right.
Okay.
That's what we're doing. And I'll show you what we do after that. All right, so we're gonna cut just the whole potato.
Oh shoot! I get to use a knife.
Oh man, I'm gonna move out the way.
Yeah, you should. I would concur with that right now.
Yeah,
tucking my fingers so I don't lose it.
That's right. Sip my tea.
Yeah, you go ahead. Keep sipping your tea, bro.
Yeah.
Skills. I don't have to ask no questions except for this little piece.
Don't cut. All right. Yeah. Okay. And so
these two pieces.
So I'm the only person on this show that gets to practice no knife safety. All right. For everybody else, I need you to practice knife safety.
Okay.
When we get to this foolishness here, all right, is it worth a pinky? Is it worth a finger to get one more little piece of potato?
I don't know when the last time I used my pinky.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, well, you're not gonna leave it here. You're not gonna leave your remnants on my table, so that's not gonna happen.
Oh my All right. God.
Now what happens here?
He stacked him like his poker chips.
Poker chips, man.
You don't like that. Play poker?
Yeah, play poker.
Yes.
You never been to one of my poker games.
Well then I never got the invite.
Oh, listen.
And I live 3 minutes that way.
Listen, the invite is coming.
Okay.
So we're gonna use one stick of butter.
Salted or unsalted?
This always salted.
Okay.
Always salted.
Gotcha.
The only time you really use sweet butter is for baking things.
Okay.
And not even then most of the time. But for the most part, we use salted butter.
Okay.
These are quarter sticks. Half sticks. So we're going to use two of these.
Okay.
And we're going to also mix in a little bit of sugar.
And this
and
is...
a bit of cinnamon.
Okay.
All right. So what I will do is grab another bowl. And like I said, with the rubs,
right,
what we're going to do is give me 3 tablespoons of sugar.
Okay, we're gonna read again.
Uh-huh.
That says teaspoon. 3 tablespoons.
3 tablespoons of sugar.
Okay.
It should be just about perfect, actually.
Okay, 1.
Mm-hmm.
2. 3.
Is that?
Yeah, it's about
that. Okay,
yeah.
All right. And 1 tablespoon of cinnamon.
1 tablespoon of cinnamon. Y'all remember that cinnamon challenge that all the kids were doing?
Yes. Crazy.
Highly stupid.
Yeah, it is. It's absolutely crazy.
Yeah, nuts.
Right. All right, so we're just going to mix that up. You can actually use one of these.
Okay.
Just mix it up. There you go. All
right.
All right, so what's going to happen is we're going to take this, we're going to open up the butter, put it in the pan, we'll let that sit for about 2 or 3 minutes until the butter melts.
Okay.
Then we're going to add that in.
Okay.
All right, and mix it all together. And then we're just gonna put the potatoes in, cover it up, and just let it simmer on a nice little flame for about 15, 20 minutes.
Gotcha, bro.
That's what happens. All right, so let's go on over to the stove. We'll do that. All
right? Let's do the walk.
Okay. Someone to hold me tight, that would be very nice. In the meantime, let's make the sauce.
Okay, gotcha.
Now, this is a chimichurri sauce, all right? Everything has been washed and prepared and everything. My cilantro is melting because we've been here for a little while. It's wilting, rather, because we've been here for a little while. Things aren't as fresh as they were this morning.
It's all right.
So here's what we're going to do. We're just going to start dicing things up, all right? So you start with a yellow pepper. I'll start with a red pepper.
All
and
right.
We'll meet in the middle somewhere.
All right. You want small dices or what?
We want it small, nice and small.
Okay.
Absolutely.
Watch my skills. Watch me work, B. I'm old school, so I call you B for everything.
You know, home skill. Let's date ourselves.
Yep.
You know what I mean? Homie, we were talking earlier when you introduced yourself. You had an education, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now, what do you do?
I'm the attendance officer for a high school in Long Island.
Okay.
Yes.
And what does that entail?
So I monitor attendance.
It means I do attendance.
Let me help you out. I hope I can answer that question.
Right.
You know, so what I do is I monitor the attendance, make ensuring that our kids, especially since we are in the pandemic, are going on remotely, reporting these numbers to New York State for our funding, and just ensuring that that we're engaging our students and getting them to do what they're supposed to do.
Okay. And, you know, I'm making jokes, obviously, but at the same time, that's got to be crazy right now with COVID because people are online learning and doing all this stuff. So how do you actually make sure that that's an accurate attendance?
Well, I have to monitor the teacher's attendance as well. So I have to monitor and make sure that they're doing what they're supposed to do. Wow. You know, so.
So your teachers are remote also?
My teachers are remote.
Wow.
Okay. We for a 2,200 student building, we only have about 40 kids who are physically in the building, and these are kids.
Out of 2,200?
Yes.
40?
Yes, 40
wow.
kids.
4-0. Wow.
Yeah. You got smaller dices than me, B. What's going on? Like, this is where my acumen is not showing right
so
now.
So when I said small,
it's all right.
You thought I meant chunks?
Well, when you get chunks,
let me show y'all the difference between a dice and a chunk. Okay.
They call this rustic. This is the rustic look.
Listen, make that a small.
One point for Gerard. 1 point for Gerard.
So,
see,
here's a question. What is it that you find most rewarding about being in education?
Well, understand that education is the only industry, right, mm-hmm. where we're expected to produce this product, but we don't know our raw materials. So we don't know where our kids are coming from, the homes, their situations. So the most rewarding thing for me is not so much about the syllabus or the curriculum. It's about getting to the whole child and developing their own personal leadership skills. Now we have to deal with their social emotional growth. Mm-hmm. You know, who are you? You know, what is their situation? How can I develop traits and qualities like empathy, leadership, truth, you know?
Gotcha.
And then you have to deal with who they are, what their starting point is. You mm-hmm. go down and you reach them.
Got to meet them where they're at.
You meet them where they're at.
Mm-hmm. And listen, shout out to you and all the teachers who've been doing what they've been doing during COVID.
Yes.
You know, it's been a challenging time. I have 3 little ones at home, as
yes.
I told you. And, you know, it's a challenge, man.
Yeah.
And I, you know, just as much as I see it's difficult for them when they're, you know, doing their remote learning,
mm-hmm.
somebody's doing the remote teaching.
Right.
Somebody's making all this stuff happen
right.
in the background. So shout out to all of the educators, all of the teachers, all of the principals, all the administrators, the sector, everybody who's doing what they're doing to make sure that our kids stay educated. My heart goes out to you.
Yes.
I really appreciate
yes.
you.
Thank you, man.
That's all
jokes aside.
I
appreciate
Absolutely.
You.
Absolutely. Listen, here's what I want you to do. This is parsley. I'm going to get you to chop this up real quick. I'm going to check and make sure that the potatoes are not simmering too much. All right. And I'll be right back.
No, no, so, no, no camera on him right now. Watch me chop this parsley. I'm going to fold it because I see them do that on TV, right? So I'm going to fold it and I'm going to do this. A rough chop with my parsley. Right?
There you go. You straight.
Nice. Okay.
Oh, shoot.
All of it. Stems, everything.
Everything. Everything.
Yep.
Beautiful.
Don't want to lose a finger, though.
Mm-hmm. Just so you know, I just went and checked on the potatoes. The potatoes have a simmering sound. I don't want sound. So I turned it even lower, okay? What we want is for it to almost steam so they get nice and soft. Chop up that cilantro.
Okay, well, you know what I saw you do? I saw you do this.
So all that is you just keeping the tip of the knife on the board.
Right.
That's all you do. Keep the tip of the knife on the board.
Oh,
pretty much no way to get hurt when you do it like that.
You know what, Gerard?
Except for this other knife that
you
just...
You know what, Gerard? You did teach me something, B. I appreciate you.
That's a killer.
You know what?
Is our insurance.
In order to lead, you must follow as 1.0.
All right, so this is a scotch bonnet, obviously, and it has a very distinct and delicious flavor, and it has a beautiful color also. These come in green, they come in yellow also.
Mm-hmm.
Because these aren't chopped just as finely as I would like,
right.
I'm going to throw them in the blender.
Okay.
That's it. We're going to throw them in the blender.
Let's get the ninja
sauce,
out.
All right? So we'll get the ninja out, and that's it. on top of the steak.
Oh my God, that's money. I'm telling
you, that's what it is right there. The potato should be just about done. Let's get in there and make the steak.
All right, that's my part. Then.
All right.
With my chef? With my chef?
You got your Foods and Dudes shirt on, man.
Listen, I need a Foods and Dudes apron. That's what I need. We're gonna move on.
Available on the website. Last piece of this puzzle is the steak itself. All right.
Okay.
So,
all right.
Been here for a couple of minutes. As you can see, the potatoes are done. These are looking
dope.
Scrumptious right now.
Right.
So that's done. What we're going to do is throw the skirt steaks on. Now, skirt steak is going to take about 2 minutes on each side. We're going to get it on, flip them, two more minutes, and that should be it. Potatoes, we have the chimchurri.
All right.
So the reason why it's covered is when it comes off the grill, mm-hmm. off the griddle, the skillet, whatever you're using.
Okay.
You want to cover this for about 10 minutes. All right.
Okay.
Steak is still cooking, so
right.
you want the internal juices to just stay inside and everything like that to give you a nice tender piece of meat.
That's where you That's say when you let it rest.
That you let it
I
rest.
Got it.
Exactly.
Yes.
And most importantly, again, I can't thank you enough for what you're doing as a teacher.
Appreciate
you, during
man.
The pandemic and, you know, making sure that our kids are still mentally fed.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
100%.
That's extremely important.
Yes.
Thank you for it.
We're going to all make it through this if we keep up the good work that we're doing.
Absolutely. All right. Listen, this has been another episode of Foods and Dudes. I want to thank you guys. Man, a boy comes through. Look what you
Big
did.
Ross, the boss. Don't forget the name.
I'm sorry.
I gotta be a little hood.
You can be a little hood, but hey, man, listen. Pick up your plate, show it to the people, because that, my friend, is how we do that.
Yes.
All right.
All right.
That's it, and that's that. Thank you, brother.
All right, bro.